In 2007, the first iPhone was introduced in the world. And now, there are more people, there are more mobile phones in Spain than there are people living in Spain. In 2007, Facebook became international. And now, 3 billion people are very active on Facebook. 70% of the Spanish people are very active on Facebook. If I ask the younger generations, if I ask my students, how they can imagine how life was before the smartphone, how they could live without a Facebook, they have no idea whatsoever. Their life is Facebook, their life are smartphones. Do you realize that if Real Madrid plays at home, there are more people watching the live match outside Spain than inside Spain? And now you can see how the world has changed. And we only see the start. We only see the start of the fourth industrial revolution. And it will change your life, it will change my life, it will change business life. If I ask my Spanish students what they want to do in the future, they have only one desire, live in Holland. Because the economic future is much better in Holland, they say to me, than in Spain. If I ask my Dutch students what they want to do, they want to live in Spain. Because the quality of life in Spain is much better than in Holland. And now we have the opportunity to do what we want. We don't have to do the same things as our parents. We can go abroad, our office is our computer, and we can change our life. We are for the first time in history in control. About the industries in the 18th century, about the steam engines, about the railways, but it hasn't changed life very much in the 18th century. In the 19th century, we called the car, we called the aeroplanes, but still, it didn't really change our life. In the 60s, we called computers, big computers, in offices, in factories, not in houses, but still didn't really change our life. And now we get internet, we get smartphones, we get personal computers. All things we have adopted as a consumer. We are using it. We are always online. We like to get information. We are buying through internet. We communicate to internet. Do you realize in the Western world, 1/3 of all the households are single person households. In England it's 45%. In America it's 50%. And the prediction is in 2025 that all over Europe about 40 and 45% people live alone. You don't need company anymore. You don't need a partner anymore because you got your mobile. and you go to computer. I can do everything you want. You don't have to go to work anymore. Work will come to you. Young people, they don't want to get old with a pension. They want to enjoy life. They don't want to own cars. They don't want to own houses. That are the baby boomers and the Y generation. They want to live. They want to be flexible and to make their own choices. And all of a sudden you see in 7 years' time the major disruption taking place. The major change in our prevalence. And the major change is taking part also in our business life. And it all has to do with the smartphone. It all has to do with the RFID chip. We talk about Internet of Things, where we can follow your car wherever you are. We can follow your plane wherever you are. We can follow you wherever we are. Forget location-based services. People know where you are because you have your smartphone on. And I never met anybody who said to me, I leave my smartphone home because otherwise they can follow me. We talk about privacy, but we know everything about you and we can react to it. Google can react to it and they will respond to everything. So everything is transparent and we can offer new products and new services to everybody. And the people say, yes, yes, but the old generation. The old generation is not old anymore. They have a smartphone to communicate with the children and with the grandchildren. And maybe they don't live in Spain, but in America or in Argentina or in South America, whatever. But still, they are connected. And that is possible in this day and age. Because they go to Facebook, or they go to Pinterest, or to Twitter. Facebook is typically a female site. And they talk about everything males don't find very relevant. But they still keep talking. Twitter is typical male site. They all talk about business, like, you know, tell them how good they are and how clever they are, how intelligent they are. Pinterest is also typical female site, sending photographs to each other of the latest fashion. There's nothing wrong with it. And LinkedIn, of course, is for people who look for a job and like to be connected and to wait until a fish will bite for them. And that's all they do. So we make all our choices. We tell people how they can connect with us. If it's business-like, you lose LinkedIn. If it's personal, you're going to use Facebook. And if it's as females together, you lose Pinterest. We males don't have that kind of sites. We go to other sites. And now you can see Spain. It's 46 million people. 35 million are active internet users. A penetration of 77%. Spain was always a bit late in the upkeep of internet. It has to do, of course, with the recession. We have it harder in Spain than in the rest of the world. But also with your culture. You have such an extrovert culture. I mean, look at outside. You're not going to sit inside the house. I mean, people in Finland, when they got hardly any sunshine, only missed a miserable people. I mean, they are on internet. They got nothing else. But you enjoy life more. You go out, you go to terraces, you go to cafes, you drink, you socialize much more till 2-3 o'clock at night. And that's why, one of the reasons that you didn't pick up internet so quick until the smartphone came. And now you pick it up extremely quick. And then you see there are 49.60 million smartphones active. You have a penetration of 107%. And if I'm here next year, you're on 125% or 130%. You have a smartphone and you have a tablet, and then we get Internet of Things. So you have all kinds of connections, and you're always able to follow. And you like to communicate. Do you realize that an average smartphone user in Spain looks at his smartphone at least 100 times a day? 100 times a day you are checking. And on a conference like this, you do maybe 200 times a day, because you're bored. And the whole time you look connections. And you want to know things, and you communicate with each other. And if you look at the social users, using the social media by smartphone, it's also about 20 million. How can you now think about a life without a smartphone? We can't anymore. So we have, in psychology, the Maslow pyramid, in which we state our needs. Of course, you need food to live, you need company, you need sex, you need water, you have to feel safe, you want friends, Of course, you want to belong somewhere, and in the end, when you've reached everything, you want to express yourself and show how clever you are and how important you are, and especially in Spain, the male importance is extremely important, of course, and that is the top. But now, you're going to look at the young people. And the young people, they want a smartphone. And they have a choice, buying a smartphone, the iPhone 7, or skipping a meal. They prefer to skip the meal and buy the smartphone. If you see that they spend about 20% of the free disposable income on smartphones and apps, on games, and much rather, they don't go out drinking, they don't go out smoking, they don't want to eat, want to eat more than enough, and they can spend all this money on a smartphone. They even take a second job, or a third job, or a fourth job, just to pay for their smartphone. And then you see all the new developments, that the smartphone is really a basic need in our life. And if you think that you are not addicted to the smartphone, leave it home tomorrow morning. And see how long it takes before your hands start to shake. On average, about half an hour. After an hour, you get a bit foam in your mouth, and a bit pale, and I doubt if it is lunchtime before you go home to pick up your smartphone. Because you feel lost, you feel lonely, and you feel disconnected. And that is the real value of today. And now all kinds of companies are using the smartphone. Not for buying, as you have heard this morning, but just for checking things, for communicating things. So the next layer is Facebook. If you are disconnected from Facebook, I mean, you get really miserable. Nobody will love you anymore. And you cannot connect with people. And the phase after the LinkedIn, of course, because that are more distant relatives, and you will want to look for jobs and still to keep in touch. But what do you think about housing? We don't want to own a big house anymore. Just a small house with a bed sitter, so we can sleep in, that's it. Or we share it, that's it. Still the baby boom generation, they want to have a second house and a third house, an expensive house, and to buy the house with high mortgages, so they are worrying thick until they have pension and they don't get the pension anymore, a miserable life. And the young people have seen it happening by the parents, by the family, and that's not the life they want. So they don't want expensive cars, they don't want expensive houses, they just want to live. And finally, we want to express ourselves. We want to show the world how brilliant we are. We are blogging, or vlogging, or telling to the people, my God, you know, see, I'm in Madrid now, see how great my life is. Even if I'm miserable, I tell everybody how great my life is. And even last weekend, somebody said to me, I'm now in the stadium of Real Madrid, I see them playing, it's great. And I thought, my God, I wish I was there. So I sent back, and I'm sitting at home, watching television, with my glass of beer, and I'm watching Real Madrid, and I can see all rehearsals. I didn't, but just to make him jealous, that I saw better than he did. So the whole time, we are in a matter of voyeurism, looking at what other people do, and exhibitionism, telling them how great we are. So we use also the smartphone, and internet, and social media for self-expression. And then you see Spain again. Do you know we spend on average about 4 hours a day active on internet, instant messaging, 57% of the users on daily basis are using services like WhatsApp, 91%, because it's free of charge and you can still connect to people, or Telegram. Social networks, Facebook, 87%, followed by Twitter and Instagram. So you see, Spain is really active on social media. They're really involving the smartphone in their life. And even shopping. Until 2014, you all shopped abroad. And in 2014, something changed. You spent more money on Spanish web shops than you did abroad, because you trust Kortingles, or Zara, or Privalia, much more than you do Amazon.com, or eBay, or whatever. So you want to just to stay at home. And all the web shops have seen it. And they help you to buy much more. And if people say, yes, yes, but Spain is behind because only 3% of the retail trade is going through internet. On average in Europe is 5%, so not very far. But you have to look, what are you buying on internet? If you look at fashion, it's about 20% is going to internet. If you look at consumer electronics, it's also about 25% on the internet. Shoes, especially because of Zalando, a more shoe offering, is about 15% of internet. So you can't compare it with the total retail sales, you have to compare it with the shops in the high street. And then you walk to Madrid, or you walk to Barcelona, or to Alicante, and you see more and more empty shops, because they don't react to the consumer. They don't react to the new behavior of the consumer. And even this morning you've heard that we use the smartphone for browsing, for checking prices, and then we go outside the shop, and we buy it by Cort & Claes, or we buy it by Zara, or we buy it by Amazon. So there's a new customer behavior we're talking about. And then you see the customer journey. And most of the times, a customer journey is just a functional process from awareness to information to research to buying after sales. But that's not the way we shop. I've never met anybody who said in a shopping experience, I'm now going to the next stage in my shopping journey. We don't. We just walk to town and we look at the shop, in the shop window, and we just go into the shops. If you talk to Spanish people, especially the females, they always go to Cort & Claes. And I said, why? He said, oh, it's marvelous. It's like paradise. And I said, what are you going to buy? He said, I never know. But I always buy something. So something takes place in our mind. It might be happiness, it might be hedonic, it might be experience, it might be want, that you want to buy something. And that is more different stages. We get the consideration phase. We check on our smartphone what the prices are, even in the shop, just to have an excuse so we can buy it in the shop. Not we're going to buy the cheapest, no, we can have it now. I did once a research and I asked all the women, it was in Holland, from if the shops offer you to take all the things that you buy to your house, what do you think about it? So just imagine you go to Cort & Claes, you do your shopping, and you go out again without having anything, and 2 hours later it is home. They don't want it, because they want to walk around with the bags of Cort & Claes or Prada and show off, I've been there and I bought it. And I've even seen in London with Primark. People buy the Primark, the cheapest, worst quality ever. They buy it, they go outside, they take it out the bag from the Primark, they put it in the bags of Harrods, and they walk on again. Oh, they go to Harrods, yes, they go to Harrods, they bought some nice things. Because you want to show off. So it is not always that it brought home. It's only because it's easy to brought home. But when you have an opportunity, especially as females, you want to show off what you have bought, and you want to show all your friends, and tell all your friends, and that is exactly what you're going to do in the post-purchase phase. You send photographs to people, and you send messages to people. I've just bought these fabulous shoes for Christmas, or the fabulous dress, or the fabulous Wi-Fi, or the fabulous computer. We males want to talk about computers, because we think we're technical, and that's different. We still want to show off, and that's why we use the smartphone. And then you see for companies, they have to rethink the whole marketing structure. They still spend so much money on Google. And who's going to Google nowadays? I mean, they have lost the impact on the search engine. They have an impact on Android, but not anymore on the search engine. And we're going to read the adverts. We're going to watch television anymore. Young people don't watch television anymore. In Europe, this year, the amount of people who watch television has dropped with 25%. And they expect next year to drop at least with 25%. So we communicate on a different way. So for companies, you don't talk anymore about radio, TV, print, but you talk about email, you talk about paid content, you talk about websites, you talk about bloggers, you talk about social media. There is your present, because the customers are there. So you have to develop a complete new approach. And the same with all the purchases, make sure that people can find you. They have a website. And now you can see a complete new development. I will talk to you a bit later about it, where you want to collaborate, to work together. You don't want to search to websites and to jump from one website to another website, and maybe through affinity or affiliate, that'll lead you through it. You make your own choice. You want to have it efficient. And you always go back to the same place you always did. You're not going to surf the internet anymore. And now we are again on a threshold in development. It was in 2002 when we saw a new breakthrough of web shops. We saw it in the 90s when Amazon came, and we saw it as an information source. And now technology is changing the world altogether, and it's going faster than ever before.
When I think about the future of digital transformation, there's an old story that I find very helpful, and it's a story about the inventor of the game of chess. The legend goes that the inventor took his creation to the Emperor of India and showed him the game. And the emperor was so impressed by the beauty and elegance of the game of chess that he said, "You can name your own reward. Majesty, I'm a humble man. All I want is a pile of rice. Put one grain of rice on the first square of this chessboard. Double that, put two grains of rice on the second square. Double that, continue on and on. And when we've got 64 squares full of rice, just give me that quantity of rice." And the emperor says, "You really are a humble man. Make it so." Now, those of us who have had a little bit of math realize how much trouble the emperor is in, because that constant doubling adds up over time, and it reaches numbers that absolutely stagger the imagination. After 32 squares, there are a few billion grains of rice, which is a lot, but that's about as much as you would get from harvesting one large field. It's only when you get in the second half of the chessboard that things get really, really strange. So by the time they've covered 64 squares of the chessboard, there's a pile of rice bigger than Mount Everest, and it's more rice than has been produced by all of humanity in the entire history of the world. When the emperor realizes how badly he's been tricked by the inventor, he has the guy beheaded. He cuts off his head. So we did some quick calculations. The United States started tracking information technology as a category of corporate investment in about 1958. And if you take the normal doubling period of Moore's Law as 18 months, you take 32 of those doubling periods and you add that to 1958, it turns out that we entered the second half of the chessboard when it comes to digital technology in about 2006. So since 2006, we've seen the explosion of social media. We've seen the arrival of smartphones and tablets. We've seen computers that can now drive cars. We've seen humanoid robots in factories. We have seen a computer be the world champion in the quiz show Jeopardy. All these things have happened since 2006. So to me, that means that we are in some new phase. Maybe we have just started the second half of the chessboard when it comes to the power and the impact of digital technologies. And if what I've just said is true, if there's any truth to it, there's one conclusion, and that conclusion is we haven't seen anything yet. And I firmly believe that the digital innovations that are going to come and that are going to affect the business world are going to be absolutely transformative in the not too distant future. If that's the case, the only smart strategy at the top of the enterprise is, again, to embrace and to start leading the digital transformation for your company.
Capgemini Consulting, transform to the power of digital.
We haven't seen anything yet. So don't look at the past. Don't copy other places where they've been quicker with the uptake of internet than Spain has. Spain had a unique opportunity to jump on the future, to do the things on a complete new way. Spain is a very open culture, so you can learn very quickly from each other. And Spain doesn't have any enemies, like the English people, or the French people, or we hate Americans, or the Germans. That isn't the case. Everybody likes Spanish people. I do anyway, but so everybody does. And that means you can move much quicker. See how quick Sara has taken over the world, the power of Telefonica, because we want to do this. And now you're going to look at your future, and you're going to look at the new opportunities we get, opportunities like the drones, or the self-driving cars, of augmented reality, or even the 3D printers. So much opportunity for the next coming years. IKEA is a company which is really based on physical presence, a really an experience shop, and they never want to embrace internet until augmented reality. And now you can download this, and you can see it in your room, and you can have the all pre-purchase process at home. And now you can buy online, because you got exactly the same feeling. Just imagine, if you can't get a ticket for Real Madrid, you just put your helmet on and your Samsung S7, and you can watch it, and you can hear it, and you can feel it if you were in a stadium. And you don't have to pay 150 euros for a ticket. You can just do it at home, alone, or with your friends, and still have the same experience. And what do you think about 3D printers? It might be in your kitchen, for your meal, or for your cups, or whatever. And this is happening right now. We still talk about traffic jams. But how long will it be that Uber has also self-driving cars, that you don't have to do it anymore? We don't have to own the car. We need just an app to do it. And now we talk about cooperations, collaborations. Do we ever realize that Alibaba doesn't have anything in stock? They don't own warehouses. You buy by Alibaba, they send your order straight to a factory, and the factory will send it to you. And they grow with about 50% a year. They got an EBIT of about 48%, and they make billions of profit. Amazon is afraid of Alibaba, because Alibaba has nothing, only a connection between sellers and buyers, and they're going to take over the world. Think about Uber, has nothing, only the app, and they just try to connect people with a car and people who need a car. Think about Airbnb. I mean, I've got a house in Gabia, and I put it on Airbnb. I did it early June. Until now, it was higher every single day, every single week. And I don't have to do anything, and I get rich without thinking about it. Not really, but I mean, you can make money out of it. And Airbnb has nothing. They only connect. And now you can think about your business, about your company. How can you just connect without owning anything? We're connecting. And maybe you don't have to do it yourself, but you can do it together with more people, with more parties. And then you can see the real change. And you can see platforms arising. Here on Marketplace with Etsy and with eBay, of payment platforms. And you have heard of Aiden, who just said, wherever you are, we will connect it for the payment. It's a typical platform. And you talk about social networks like Tinder and like Facebook and like Twitter. And they're all connecting. And you only go to one website. So you can just imagine you go to one website for your holidays and you can arrange your car, your plane ticket, your house, everything you want. And if you are not part of the platform, you have no future. So you have to think about these platforms. And they are going to break through very quickly now. So what is here happening? There's a lot of things happening. And all has to do with connectivity, with interactivity. And all has to do with sharing information and collaborating, working together in all kinds of platforms. Don't think about your own website anymore, but try to do it together. Offer the facilities. Connect to the people on the way the people want. If you want to shop at 10 o'clock at night, you shop at 10 o'clock at night. If you just want information, do it. And do it on a very personal level. But you see the start of big data. We have to analyze it. In a few years' time, maybe even not a few years' time, the major value of a company is customer data, behavioral data, big data, analysis systems, so we exactly know what happens. And because of the smartphone, you give me all this information, free of charge, so I have to do something with it. I have to make you happy with it. I have to get the information that makes you happy. So we don't talk about push or pull anymore. No, I know you. And I'll make you happy in the moment that you want to be happy with whatever you want.
Thank you.
We just entered the second half of a chessboard. We enter a time of disruption. And I will give you one advice. Go back to your company tomorrow. And you think this disruptor will kill you within 1 year time. They will be there. In Spain or outside. They will re-change the rules of the game. And you cannot defend by just a web shop or doing the same things, only better. You have to do it better. You have to do it different. Just what the customers want. And if you are not prepared to take the decision within 1 year or within 2 months, then you have to be prepared that you have no future. Thank you.